All right, so here we are. I'm going to go over how to create tracks, insert some instruments, create a song based on the information that I am giving you in this exercise that's up on Google Classroom. So we have spoken about all this in class. We've already talked about drum patterns and rhythms, quarter notes, eighth notes, 16th notes, 30 seconds. We've talked about how to, we clapped out some rhythms when we looked at different, where the kick drum and the snare drum lie, kick on 1 and 3, snare on 2 and 4, hi-hat playing a different kind of pattern. So to cut to the chase, I am going to remake the drum part just so that we can all be on the same page in case you miss class. So basically, you have a stereo instrument track. I'm going to double click on the nameplate. I'm going to call it drums. Naming your instruments early is always good. I already have one of these hidden, so I will just add a number to it. I am going to insert the multi-channel instrument plugin called Battery. And I'm not going to go in and explain everything about this, but I am still have up and ready the Realist kit, which is what we're going to use. I'm double clicking on that. We're going to be using the kick, which is triggered by C1, the snare, which is triggered by D1, and the hi-hat, which is triggered by G#1. And I'm kind of circling the key range so that you can remind yourself of that. So these are already loaded. I'm just going to close this up. I'm going to bring up the MIDI editor, and I am going to, interesting, that's the hidden one right now. That is the pattern that we're going to put in, but I'm going to go ahead and do it in real time. So we're going to put a kick right there, C1, D1, I'll go ahead and put our snares on 2 and 4. Pretty sure that is the pattern that I told you to do. Yes, there is a quicker way than individually clicking in these 16th notes, but that's what I'm doing. Okay, so that was the main pattern. Coming back to the MIDI, to the edit window, using my grabber tool to select from beginning to end, hitting duplicate, double clicking with my grabber tool to get back in here to the MIDI editor. I'm going to change my grid resolution to 30 seconds and put in a little drum fill, a little snare fill. Okay, so those are 30-second notes. You can see the relationship next to that last 16th note snare drum. That is it. And what we're going to do in class today, and I'm going to kind of sneak it in here, is a video. Talk a little bit about shuffle mode. So by shuffle mode, when I have this first one, this first clip highlighted, if I choose to duplicate it, you can see that it just shuffles this third, now it's the fourth one, over to the right. That's really one of the only uses for shuffle. The other one would be I want to take this one and actually make it the second in the order, and that shuffles those out of the way. But I don't. I want to leave that as the fourth, so that every fourth measure we have a little drum fill. All right, so the drums are done. We're going to make a new track. We'll make it stereo instrument. In fact, yeah, we'll go ahead and make one. Then I'll show you that you can hit this plus sign, and I'm going to go ahead and make a mono instrument track looking ahead for the bass that we're going to use, and that is it at the moment. So this is the stereo one. I'm going to make this keys, and then I will hit next and name that one bass. And I am adding these numbers because I have some existing tracks, whatever. All right, so I'm going to insert for the keys. I like to just start. I'm going to start with expand. I'm going to load up a pretty generic electric piano, the Mark II, and I'm just going to start there. At this point, I just want to remind you, we're going to put in these three chords, the G-flat, which is made up of G-flat, B-flat, and D-flat, the E-flat minor, the D-flat, okay? X marks the spot. So if I go to my MIDI editor, I'm going to choose keys three. There it is. I'm going to say that this should be done in the second octave, and I might change that, but I'm going to start with my F sharp. And this is going to play for one measure. measure. So I'm going to draw it out to be one full measure, all the way up to beat one of measure two. My A sharp or B flat. And the last one is C sharp. Okay, and actually we want two of these chords. We could duplicate those notes, but we can draw them as well. All right. So we have that essentially that that chord, the G flat, is playing for two measures. But I don't want to just hold it for two measures. I want it to actually hit again. It's a little hard to see because my grid is set to 30 seconds. Easier to work there. Now we're going to go to the E flat minor, which shares the G flat and the B flat. But we drop our root down to E flat. So that's what I'm going to draw first, is the E flat for a measure. And then third chord is D flat, so it's D flat, F, and A flat. Here's D flat, F, and A flat. Okay, that's our keys part. Alright, so see that we have now just a perfect symmetry. If for any reason you end up with like some extra clip, just remember that you can always use your trim tool. Bring that back where we want it. Alright, for bass, I'm going to start with expand again. So that's how I roll. And I'm just going to go to number 10, the clicky D and B bass. It's a pretty solid little starting point. Go to my MIDI editor, choose my bass. Now remember, bass is going to play the root an octave below the chords. So here we're in the first octave, you can tell. And what this is showing you is that these notes are going to play for one quarter note and two sixteenths. The grid set to 16, so that's how I'm saying it, but essentially an eighth note. So that is G flat. So we'll go ahead and go to G flat in the first octave right there. Draw it in. Then the next one falls on beat two and does the same thing. Plays for 1.5 beats. Then right before beat four, we drop our next note. So three G flats, one kind of transitional E flat, okay, and then we hit two D flats, D flat, D flat, and that is at measure four, D flat. Lengthen that one. All right, our bass part's done. We're going to go ahead and use our grabber tool again. I'm going to keep doing it in the smart tool. And if we hold down the shift key on our keyboard, then we can select multiple clips across tracks. I'm going to hit command D to duplicate this. And I'm going to duplicate it about 15 times or so. Okay, I might be off on that. Hitting return. I want to make sure that we have changed our tempo. We started off at 68. Let me put that back. I'm going to demonstrate that because nothing's better than just demonstration. Alright, we won't really be able to tell just by listening to it. I don't think that it's a little bit slower. Now we're going to learn how to import some audio. So I go to File, Import Audio, and this is all under the assumption that you have the Audio Production Share Drive mounted. Go into Audio Production, into Share, and you know, this file might change here and there, but within the Digital Music Production folder, I have put an a cappella vocal track. It's a WAV file, and it is, you can tell here, it's a 24-bit, 44.1 stereo track. I'm just going to say, click on it once to see it in the current file window. We're going to copy it so that it shows up as a clip to import, and this word copy here, as opposed to adding, which I'm not going to get into, just copy it. We're going to hit done. We will hit open. This is the destination folder. It is the audio files folder within your session exercise 3 folder. This is going to take a minute to process. So this is sitting on that server over in the D-Wing. It's processing. Now a window is going to pop up to say, what do you want me to do with this track? Would you like me to create a host track for it and I'll place the clip right at the session beginning? Or would you like it just to show up in the clip list? And we want it to go to a new track at the session start. And we go, all right? Now, don't cut anything here. This is an intro. It's planned that way. But I want you to hear how this comes in.
So you're still thinking of me, just like I know you should.
So either Khalid has no rhythm, or the song, our music is just too slow for this recorded vocal track. And that actually is the case. So if you come back, remember to hit return and click on your tempo plus sign. And we're going to change this tempo from 68 to 68.5. And that half a BPM, if you saw that shift, I'm going to undo that. And just as I redo this, watch how the music shifts over to the left, because it has kind of compressed itself into a shorter time frame, because it's going to play half a beat faster per measure per minute, which is actually quite significant. So let's listen now.
So you're still thinking of me, just like I know you should. I cannot give you everything, you know I wish I could.
All right, if I zoom out, it looks like my 15 copies of those four measures were wrong.
Young, dumb, broke high school kids.
Okay, we'll call it that. Now, if you're here, these are all starting sounds. I would like to go and change them up. So I could go ahead and get rid of this instrument and just go no insert and change it, or just change it for that matter. But I kind of like the electric piano. So I'm going to duplicate the track. And I'm just going to duplicate the whole thing, including the inserts, including the MIDI data. And now I'll go to this dupe track, which is the new track, and I'm going to change that one to be massive. And just so I can kind of play around with the sounds on its own, I'm going to solo it. I'm going to click over to browser so I can look at the attribute-driven presets database. And I think I want a pad, so I'll narrow it down to that. Outside of that, I'm not sure. Do I want it to be basic? Sure, let's see.
Thank you.
full loading, I can live with it, but it becomes too low. So what I'm going to do is come in here, double click into my MIDI editor. That leaves this first measure highlighted. If I hit Command A, I'll highlight everything so that if I move this one note, I'm going to move it up an octave because that particular preset sounds a little funky to me in the lower octave. Okay, so if I bring that in and kind of listen to the keys, I think I want it lower. So I'm kind of getting the attack of the electric piano, but the sustain of the pad. That it sounds right to you, okay? I would say that that's probably where we're at.